This is a continuation of the last video where we came up with a shortcut method for finding one of the correct factors. In a later video, I'm going to explain exactly why this works. So, first of all, we want to use the idea of the product and sum, and the product comes from the first coefficient times the constant at the end. So 6 times 21 is 126. And the sum is the middle term, which is 23. Both of these are positive, so our two numbers are both going to be positive in this case. So let's list out the factors of 126. 1 goes into 126. 2 goes into 126. 3 goes into 126. Let's see, that would be 42 times. 4 does not go into any of these numbers. 5 does not go into any of those numbers. 6, yes, 6 goes into 42, so that's 7 times 3 is 21, which of course that was the original. We multiplied together to get 126, the 6 times 21. 8 does not go into any of the numbers. 9 does go into the number. A little trick here is the digits of 126 add up to 9. Anytime that happens, 9 will divide evenly into the number. So 9 goes into 126. Well, let's see. 9 goes into 63. 7 times 2, it's going to be 14. Or you could get out a calculator and figure that out. So what we're looking for is which two numbers, which set of numbers adds up to 23. And there it is, the 9 and 14. Okay, after we do that, then we take the first term, the 6x squared, and instead of writing the next term, which is 23x, instead we write one of these as its coefficient. So I could either put 9 or 14. I'll just pick 9. And then you factor out the greatest common factor. So that's going to be 3x times 2x plus 3. What you get in parentheses is going to be one of the factors over here. So now we come over here. 2x plus 3 is one of the factors. So let's figure out what the other factor is. 2x times what will give you 6x squared? 3x. And 3 times what will give you 21? 7. So that should be the correct answer. Of course, you should check by doing the FOIL method. And what you'll notice when you do the FOIL method is that the inner and outer terms will be have these coefficients, 9 and 14, the ones you chose here. When you do the FOIL method, that's what the two coefficients should be of the middle terms. Notice that's exactly what happens here. If I do 2x times 3x is 6x squared, the outer term is 14x, the inner term is 9x, and the last term is 21, and so it checks. So that's the correct factorization, 2x plus 3 times 3x plus 7. So this actually is a shortcut for doing factoring by grouping, which I will be covering later if you really want to understand it more, which I recommend. But right now we're just going, sometimes it's nice just to be able to do it, and then the understanding comes a little bit later. Let's try this one. Factor 9x squared plus 3x plus 2. All right, so if we do the product and sum idea again, remember the product is the 9 times the 2. So the product is 18, and the sum has to be 3. And again, they're both positive, so we know the signs of both numbers will be positive. So 1 times 18, 2 times 9, 3 times 6, and those are all the factors, the pairs of factors that are 18. Which one of these adds up to 3? None of them. Be careful. You might look at that 3 and 6 and say, hey, that's the right combination, 6 minus 3, but they're both positive because the product's positive. The sum's positive, so they're both positive. They add up to 9. So this one does not factor. Since it doesn't factor, we would either say that it's prime. That's a correct way of expressing your answer, or we could say it's non-factorable over the integers. Okay, either one of those are a correct way of writing the answer. Let's go on to another one. Here's another one to factor. Again, what are we going to do to get the product and sum? It's 3 times negative 16. So the product is negative 48, and the sum is the middle term of 22. So first we want to just list pairs of factors that multiply out to be 48. So we've got 1 and 48, 2 and 24, 3 and 16, 4 and 12, 5 doesn't go into it, 6 times 8, 7 doesn't go into it, and we're done because 7 times 7 is already bigger than 48. All right, since the sum is positive, positive goes in front of the larger number, and the product is negative, so these must be opposite signs to get a negative 48. So the other number must be negative. All right, so we want to look at those combinations and see if any add up to the sum of 22. And here it is. Okay, so next step, you take the first term of the original problem, 3x squared, and one of these numbers, I could either pick the negative 2 or the 24. How about just the minus 2x? You have to put the x next to it, though. So you're going to put the same variable as the middle term here. All right, what's the greatest common factor here? X. So it's 3x minus 2. That's one of the factors. So 3x minus 2 is one of the factors. All right, 3x times what will give you 3x squared? X. And negative 2 times what will give you negative 16 plus 8. And that should be the correct factorization. And you should check your answer by doing the FOIL method. And when you do, the inner and the outer terms, you should get, one of them will end up being 24x and the other one will be negative 2x. Do you see it? The outer term is plus 24x and the inner term will be negative 2x. That's what you're finding when you do the product and sum here. I just want to pause for a moment here and talk about factoring. When you're factoring, there, like I said in the other video, there are several different methods, but in the end, you have to get the two correct factors. The same is true of numbers. If I say factor 6, the answer is 2 times 3, but one person may have figured that out differently than you figured it out. So this is just how to figure out how to factor this. There isn't really just one method that you have to use, but you do have to make sure you check your answer, and that when you do the FOIL method or the box method, you're going to get right back to where you started. That's the most important point. The second point I want to make is that, honestly, I don't do it this way. I do trial and error because it's faster once you get the hang of it. But until you get the hang of it, it might be easier to go through this kind of methodical way of listing the product and the sum. That's really up to you. And I'm going to show you other ways to factor. If one way makes the most sense to you, stick with it. What really matters is, can you get the correct factors? And in fact, that's true in pretty much all of math. If you know how to add, I don't really care how you learned how to do it. When you add numbers, if you keep getting the right answer, you must hopefully be doing something right. Okay, so that's it for this video. Those are just a few more examples. And if you just keep going on, I'm going to show you more factoring methods and eventually why this all works and makes sense.